Blackstone Audio presents The Great Reminder, a Moroni Traveler novel by R.R. Irvine. This book is read by Jeffrey Kafer.
1. As usual, Brigham Young was creating a traffic jam at the head of Main Street. He'd been standing there in brawn since the horse and buggy era. Behind Moroni Traveler, someone honked repeatedly. Gentile. Traveler muttered on Brigham's behalf. Double-lane traffic had come to a standstill at the point where South Temple shrank to a single buggy-sized lane. Through it all, Brigham stood his ground, looking majestic atop his granite pedestal. He'd been leaning on his cane there in the middle of Main and South Temple streets for nearly 100 years. At his feet, a bronze cast of characters, an Indian, a fur trader, and a pioneer family kept him company. Half a block beyond the Mormon leader, the afternoon sun was hiding behind the Chester building where Traveler had his office. He glanced at the dashboard clock. He was late. No doubt his prospective client was already into the yellow pages, seeking a replacement. Once through the intersection, Traveler parked illegally in front of the Chester building and climbed the 3 flights of stairs rather than wait for the elevator. Outside his office, a well-dressed elderly man stood hunched over an aluminum cane. When Traveler opened the door for him, the man gently tapped the rubber tip against the frosted glass panel and scowled. It says Moroni Traveler and Son. My father's out of town, Traveler said. Then you're the one I spoke to on the phone. Traveler nodded at the chair on the client side of his desk. 4 feet away, his father's desk had its own client's chair. As I informed you when I called, I'm Major Lewis Stiles, U.S. Army retired. Long retired, Traveler thought. The man, now holding himself rigidly erect like a soldier awaiting inspection, looked 80 at least. His dark gray suit hung on him loosely. The collar of his white shirt was a size too big despite a tightly cinched regimental tie. Once seated, he balanced his metal cane squarely across his thighs before adding a time-worn 2-strap briefcase to his lap. When you called, Traveler prompted, you asked for an immediate appointment. Major Stiles' arthritic hand showed a maze of blue veins as he transferred his briefcase to the floor beside his chair. Free of it, he pointed a crooked finger at the open window behind Traveler. I came here directly from the temple across the street. Traveler started to swing around to join in the view of Salt Lake City's Mormon landmark, then caught himself and kept his eyes on his prospective client. May I ask you something personal, Mr. Traveler? Traveler nodded. Are you one of us? Are you LDS? The closest I come is people threatening to baptize me when I die. Stiles leaned back and appeared to think that over. After a moment, he sighed. What do you think of cemeteries, Mr. Traveler? Traveler looked for signs of humor in the man's face, but found only deep wrinkles and sad blue eyes. I'm a private detective, not a philosopher. Stiles pursed his lips, lurched to his feet, and hobbled across the office to the other east-facing window. He swayed momentarily after coming to a stop. A steady breeze, warm for so late a May afternoon, came through the open window and stirred the few strands of white hair that fringed the major's head. Traveler rose to his feet but stayed behind the desk. From there, he could see over the man's shoulder to the snow-capped Wasatch Mountains, looking coldly molten in the late afternoon sun. When I was your age, Stiles said. I never thought much of cemeteries either. But each time I pass one these days, it calls out to me. Old man, it says, your time's up. You belong to me. He thumped the floor with the tip of his cane before leaning his weight on it. I'm glad you're not one of us, Mr. Traveler, despite being named for our angel. He nodded to himself and turned around. I have a feeling this is a job for a Gentile, not a saint. Traveler settled back into his chair. Cross ventilation brought the scent of mountain sage and juniper in from the east and out the temple-facing window. He breathed deeply and prodded the major with an encouraging smile. There's a time factor involved. Stiles lifted his cane until it was pointing at Traveler. Without the stick support, he wobbled slightly. That's why I want to get things started as soon as possible. He peered at Traveler for a moment, then grunted as if satisfied with what he saw. Cemeteries, Mr. Traveler. They'll get you two in the end. My father's a great one for pioneer graveyards. Looking for relatives like the rest of us, I...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.